Slums CTF.
Yeah, so Slums Capture Flag, we've been talking about it. So when you spawn on the bottom side, obviously you want to focus more on blue control, whereas if you spawn on the top side, you want to try to implement this spawn trap over near the cop car. And the complexity you're able to get that going, well, it's just going to be relays for days.
Secure the
objectives. JCap on your screen. Scumpy is going to go straight with them to the bricks. They're going to send Big T and Nade Shot to lock down blue. The complexity split, two at bricks as well. One to blue. Early kill goes to JCap. Just like that, he takes out Iggs. Nade Shot in the kill feed on Krim as well. And the battle looks to be won by Optic after that one on Clayster. A nice start here from the Optic boys.
Well, look at your minimap, TP. He's already at the Optic flag, ready to go for a pull, relying on his teammates to pick up the kills around the map. And TP can make a play happen at any time. But you see three down right now for complexity. TP has to make a decision.
Yeah, and Optic's aware of it. They just called it out. They're hunting for that player. JCap coming behind him right now. TP on the stairs. JCap's looking everywhere, but TP's nowhere to be found, and TP's gonna grab the flag. And not only that, he's got blockers. The flag is being returned. JCap keeps it alive for the moment, now going for the kill on TP. And I think Inks just got it.
Inks
just got the return. This is gonna be a cap from TP. And TP puts it in, 1-0. Complexity, they lose the intro battle, but TP, too smart, the objective mastermind, gets the support he needs and puts it in after just a minute five.
Man, JCap was looking in every single corner at the back of his base. Teep was right on the middle stairs. JCap just didn't get the right angle, but here comes Big Timer pulling a flag for Optic Gaming, but he's all alone, has to pick up these kills.
Big D looking, no van love this time. And that flag is returned by Clayster, who is on a three kill spree, hit with the EMP. So he can't see his score streaks, but he's got to be close. There's another kill with the long range. Semtex takes out Scumpy. JCap going to answer back on TP, but Aches is in the kill feed as well. And I think it looks like Complexity has total control. Look at this, Crim6 also flanking behind all four members of Optic.
This is a perfect play. They know that they have mid-map control. They know that Optic Gaming is turtle up inside the blue building. That means that they're not going to be spawning on the street. Crim6 realizing this, and now he's making plays on the flag.
And here comes TP to run that flag again. Krim goes down. TP's got to fight his way out of this one. Has cover from Clayster on cop car side. Another kill from TP. The man is going huge. Clayster going to try and rally it.
Pick up the flag.
And he will not get out of there. Here comes Iggs. Can he stop all three? Gets one. Will not get the other. Scumpy will get the kill as JCap gets the return.
Good defensive hold by Optic, but the damage is done. Clayster picking up the flag, gets plus 100. Now he has a lightning strike and a hellstorm missile to work with, so streaks are required for
flag has been taken.
Flag being pulled once again by TP. Big Timer trying to get the cutoff. JCap also on your screen is going to focus on the overextension. The spawn's back garage. JCap's going to have to fight his way out.
Yeah, I think Crimson turned on a player right there, but Optic going for a flag pull. Shut down immediately. Complexity, they've been in complete control of this game ever since TP just went huge at that flag.
And here you see Aches getting picked off. Clayster still alive though in the middle, has the Hellstorm, has the Lightning Strike. Optic really not getting very far on this map, always getting stopped in the center. And here are your stats after the first 3 minutes, 15 seconds, 10 and 4 from Clayster. Aches is also positive at 10 and 8. TP only 4 kills, but only 6 deaths and a flag cap already. A very slow but patient game. They're outslaying all members on Optic.
I mean, Optic, they're doing a great job holding blue, holding onto the spawns, but Complexity are just making plays happen. They're not afraid to flank around through the street and try to, you know, get around behind the Optic space. But here we go, Optic, it's gonna be JCap making move onto the Complexity flag.
Yeah, Nate Shot was just picked off, and there's another big stop. Aches is in the kill feed there. Clayster as well with the stop on JCap. Just 70 seconds left in this round, and Complexity sneaking out another flag. This one in traffic will get stopped on the blue stairs. Aches, though, coming into support, is gonna get two there. JCap was so weak from the first battle, and now Aches is gonna run this one blue. There is a member of Optic at his base. That's Big T. Can Big T get this one home, and can someone stop Aches? You gotta think about Clayster's score streaks here.
Here comes the lightning strike from Clayster. There goes Big Timer. There goes Scumpy, picking up two in the middle of the map. And here comes Clayster trying to make this return happen so his team can capture a second flag. Gets the nade out, doesn't connect. The flag is alive.
All right, JCap will keep this one alive. We have Aches on your minimap holding the other flag all the way back at his fountain. I don't know if anyone's gonna be able to get there, but just like that, down goes two players. Scuffy gets cut down, but Nate Shot is still here. Nate Shot won't win that battle. Aches defending himself and getting the War Machine. J-Cap getting Hellstorm.
Oh,
that's
Clay
a triple!
Star!
A triple from Clay!
And
can
Crimson,
they get the return? Can
Crimson,
Crim get
going
there?
For it. Kills Big Timer. He's got to die for it. 2 seconds. They're going to get it.
Oh,
they're
going
to catch
goodness.
Up Flag going into the half. Complexer now up 2-0, and they got a War Machine.
Look at Mr. X's intensity. This Complexity squad is just rolling through Optic. Fantastic teamwork. The triple kill from the Hellstorm from Clayster opened it up. Crim winning the one-on-one versus Big T, getting there with 1 second left on the clock, a 2-0 lead going into the half.
Way to be aggressive with your score streaks, man. That's how you do it. Look at the scoreboard, Puckett. Aches and Clayster, they are going off right now. 16-9, 17-8. Aches also has a capture to his name. I gotta see what kind of score streaks they got. Aches fully streaked out. Crimson got nothing, so it's only Aches with score streaks to use for Complexity.
And the boys from Optic have been in their base several times. You see four returns.
Oh, man.
And Clayster and Crimson just cleaned house. 5 for Clayster, 3 kill spree for Crim. Both players working on score streaks again, but actually Clayster's 3 came from that Hellstorm. Crim is going to lock down blue, and it looks like Optic, they're going to have a strong defensive stand at the start of this round. The question is, can they make a strong offensive push?
I mean, we'll see. At the start of this half, they went 4 down, which allowed Complexity, even though they got taken off, down from their initial push when Optic respawned. Now they have complete control of the blue side of the map. This is exactly what Complexity wants.
You see the mini map in the bottom right-hand corner. Big T lit up. Nade Shot now on your screen, trying to challenge, but Crim, he's coming closer and closer, moving from blue. Crim is going to get the kill. Does he get aggressive and go for the flag? You see the Optic arrows all looking for Crim. This is easy work for Crim. Gets one, Aches gets two. Can't Scuffy stay alive? No, the Hellstorm, the Lightning, it's all acquired here, and he's now got the War Machine.
And he's gonna waste no time pulling it out. That is 2 sets of streaks that Complexity have to use. Keep in mind, Aches, he's still fully streaked out. They're in a great position.
How is Complexity doing this? Optic Gaming is one of the best teams in Call of Duty Black Ops 2 in the world, Revan. They finished 3rd at the Call of Duty Championships, but they are simply getting outclassed here at the MLG Fall Invitational.
I mean, keep in mind, at the Call of Duty Champs, it was a completely different game being played. We had the FAL, we had the machine pistol, so that definitely played a factor into, you know, Optic's and Envy's success as well. But right now, Complexity, they're just being so aggressive alongside the whole map. Optic, it just seems like they're just turtling inside their base. You rarely see them in the middle of the map.
You can't get past Crim 6, man. A nasty two-piece picks up the MSMC, still has full streaks. 3 minutes left on the clock, and Complexity, they're not slowing down. They're all rushing through the garage. Crim 6, the lone man back at his base playing D. And you're going to see TP go for this flag. Clayster now needing to keep it alive. The double with the lightning strike from Crim 6, but this flag didn't get out.
Yeah, that's only one of the many streaks that Complexity have left to use. 2 minutes, 30 seconds remaining in the half. And, you know, it's just a slaying, dominating fight right now from Complexity. They're up in all the categories. Clayster's only died 11 times. Crim's only died 15. Aches has only died 15. Teep only 14.
Nade Shot pushing for that flag. He's waiting for support, knows he's beyond enemy lines. Gets one on Aches, gonna keep this flag alive. And one more kill, we'll give him streaks. Can he get TP here? Needs to stay alive. TP missing left, goes for the reload. Nade Shot will finish the kill, gets the Hellstorm, and the crowd here in Florida making noise. But no, they forget. Aches uses the lightning, gets the return, and just like that, all the work from this Optic Gaming team goes to waste, and Aches riddling the dead bodies with bullets, man.
Yeah, shooting some bodies. Aches letting them know about it. Nice score streak usage as well. You know, just trying to lightning strike for a return there. And time's starting to wind down. Optic don't have much seconds left to play with.
Minute 33 left on the clock. Optic in do or die mode. Aches not going to let it happen. Another two piece on bricks. Crim 6 pulling out the War Machine. It is not looking good. Optic, they need to go for the lightweight. They can't equip the flak jacket, and Crim is well aware of it here.
Yeah, he has a War Machine and a spawn trap right now. He knows that Optic are spawning over near the white wall. So he's just letting it rain as they rotate back to back laundry. But it looks like Optic, they're going to hold on to their base. But I just don't think they have enough time to play with.
Yeah, do you know who else has a War Machine? Aches. And he's going to get his 3rd flag return of the game. And look at that. four returns for Aches now. 27-18, 26-14 for Clayster. And Krim, 27-18. All three players looking to hit the 30 bomb. Are there enough Optic players left alive to slay, though? That is the question. Aches with another kill on Big Timer.
Yep. He's having a little fun in this game. It's over. Complexity have this map in the bag. They're going to go up 3-0 in the grand finals. They've yet to drop a map this entire tournament.
Looking perfect here at the end of Black Ops 2. They want to go into MLG Columbus as the number one seed. They basically already got their championship bracket seed wrapped up after this one, finishing in the top two at our Fall Invitational. The question is, how many pro points will they have at the end of this event?
Well, they have well over 100,000 right now as a team, so IO Aches Dinner made a bet with them a while back at PAX that if they could reach that mark, I'll take them out to a nice candlelit dinner.
Oh, nice.